So how's it going, Ethan?
You know, I'm busy. Busy would be the best word. Yeah.
This is the second person now I've had on the podcast named Ethan, back to back, and it's a little weird. I thought about that. I was supposed to have one in between, but everybody just wants to say fuck you. Like, come on, man.
So what was the other's Ethan response when you asked how things were going?
He said pretty good.
He said pretty good?
Yeah, and then I think I said I'm doing pretty fantastic, which I always am.
Good.
No, he was really great. He's actually going to come on a little bit more. He works at Wild Ride. Do you know the brewery?
Yes.
Have you ever been down there?
I'm very familiar with the Wild Ride.
Cool.
Great spot.
yeah, so he works down there as a beer tender, but he also brews his own beer as well.
Okay.
So he's going to come back on in another one, and I was going to talk about it when he does come back on, but hey, whatever. We're going to actually just brew beer on one.
Sweet. Have you brewed beer before?
Mm-mm.
It's a process.
Yeah.
It's
He said we'll be able to just like do it on here, start it cooking, and then it's like a good 2 hours before you do something else.
Yes.
So then we'll be able to come sit back down until we wait. And then there's 2 weeks until, you know, we have to, until we can drink it.
Exactly.
So then I have to have him on another podcast so then we can drink it.
Right.
Try our shitty beer that we come up with.
I wish you the best luck.
Thank you.
Hopefully it doesn't turn out vinegary like my attempts.
Oh, yeah? Have you brewed beer?
Twice. One time we brewed an American-style lager.
Okay.
Half the batch was drinkable. The other half was shit. And then we tried it one more time, and we went for like a darker lager.
Okay.
The entire thing, vinegar. So that was my last attempt.
Oh, man. You're like, I'm not going to do this anymore.
No, fuck that.
This is ridiculous.
Well, think about it.
Vinegar.
Think about it. You have that, like, three-hour cook process, and then 2 weeks of, like, anticipation. You know, I'm going to drink my beer. And then you crack the first one, and it's like, oh.
I should have just went and bought a fucking six-pack.
Exactly. Exactly.
So, like, a darker lager. Yeah. See, I'm not a big fan of lagers. Do you, like, I mean, are you?
You know what? I don't really like lagers. I grew up drinking IPA. I mean,
I
like that
I'm
shit.
Right there.
Yeah.
Kind of.
I mean,
when you grow up, though, you pretty much drink shit beer until you get older.
Yeah.
Plus, they really didn't have a lot of good beers way back in the day. I wonder what some of the first ones were.
So,
I mean, there's a shit ton here, but I wonder what the first IPA. I'm going to think Sierra Nevada.
You know, I don't know. I put money on it that Sierra Nevada put out one of the first American IPAs. The first brewery, the first microbrew in the United States was Anchor. Anchor Steam. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, so their Anchor Steam lager was, you know.
See, I can't consider a lager, though, a microbrew.
But they have the... Why not?
Because it's just what it is now. It's just a light beer.
Well, the Anchor Steam Pine was like out of San Francisco, small little thing.
Oh, okay.
Very local, and now what you have?
Thousands.
Yeah.
No, I don't know. Yeah. I don't think there's that many. I know there's a shit ton here.
Oh.
I want to say there's close to 30, I think now in Central Oregon.
And that's Central Oregon alone. You look
that's
at
a
the
lot.
Entire state, and you're like,
we still make this some of the best. Let's find out though. I want to know who made the first IPA. This thing probably won't tell me. It'll be like, I don't even know what an IPA is. I wonder if we can add. Yeah.
Are you looking to see who made the first, like the very first?
Yeah, I'd like to know who made the very first IPA.
Well, it was in English. I know this random fact.
You do know it. Okay.
Yeah, I know where it comes from.
Well, then I'm going to Google it, and we're going to find out if you're correct, sir.
All right, I want to know what it says.
Created IPA.
Who knows? Maybe what I heard is rumor.
Okay. But you think it's from England?
I'm near positive, but I'm willing to fact check myself.
Well, if my computer would actually run.
Here, look,
we'll just fucking sit here forever.
Look at this on my phone.
Yeah, there you go.
I'm actually going to ask
Siri. We got phones,
Siri.
We got computers. None of them. No, Siri's going to be worse.
Let's try this shit.
No, Siri sucks.
Who invented IPA?
Yeah, but does it know a beer?
Myth one. IPA was invented by a brewer called George Hodgson from Bow in East London.
Is that what you thought? So myth number one.
Okay, busted. Fact. Myth. Hodgson was the best known of the early exporters of pale ale to India.
Okay.
But there's no evidence that he invented the beer. Pale ale was already brewed in England before Hodgson.
So pale ale was... Yeah, pale ale's... I mean, that makes sense. So it's a pale ale. And then they started... And then they started calling it IPA. Why'd they call it an IPA?
Kicked it up. Well, so to get it from England to India, they needed to be able to preserve it because that time on the boats, the beer went bunk. So they're like, okay, let's kick this shit up with hops.
No shit.
And it increased the alcohol content, changed the flavor, and acted as a preservative. So by the time they got to England, they were still drinking good beer.
Huh.
Yeah.
Got it.
Yeah.
But probably by that time, it was a pale ale.
Yeah, it's probably started as a pale ale.
Yeah. No, I was thinking that it would end, right? Because you're saying that it's losing flavor as it swashes around.
Well,
by the time it got to England, they went from IPA to PA.
Well,
you know what I mean?
Yeah, I do. I am hearing what you're saying. Yeah, I'm not a beer brewer, so you know, I'm the wrong guy to ask.
I know. I don't know shit about it. I just like to drink it, so whatever. It's cool. But there's some. So yeah, you've been pretty busy. Why don't you tell me what you do?
I own a pizza restaurant, D Pizza, right here in Redmond, Oregon. We're about 4 months in, and
that's right.
We're having a hell of a time.
Very nice. That's awesome, dude. I've been there a few times. Every time it's good.
And I appreciate that.
I fucking dig it. Yeah.
I appreciate that.
I definitely. It's good stuff. So where? Why pizza?
Pizza is a necessity. Every small town's got to have good pizza. And you know what? To be honest, in my opinion, there was shit for pizza here. So
yeah,
I felt that I'm filling that void.
I gotcha. Yeah, we have a few like pizzeria style ones. I don't know. What would you consider your style of pizza though? Because it's definitely different than anything I've ate around here. Like you're saying.
Okay, like
it's different.
The reason why it's different is we make our sauce in house. We use all fresh ingredients, fresh herbs, and it's a 35-40 year old recipe.
Oh,
so
really?
It's not going to be something,
fuck, dude.
It's not going to be something you can find around here. You know.
Did you find the recipe in like some old lady's cabinet or something? You're telling me a 40 year old recipe? How are you gonna?
So
you're not 40.
So me and my friends broke into this house when we were like 14 years old.
No, this is a lie, right?
This is coming out complete bullshit.
Is it bullshit?
Totally bullshit.
Well, then tell me the truth. I don't want to hear bullshit.
My father has owned restaurants since the late 70s, and one of those restaurants was a pizzeria, a very successful pizzeria that still exists in LA today.
Oh, cool.
And
good. Shout it out. Maybe someone from LA will be like, hey, damn, that's cool. No, please put it on there because then I can put it on YouTube.
Louise's Trattoria in Los Angeles, I believe, is where this recipe originally comes from. My dad was one of the original executive chefs of this restaurant, and I'm using that original recipe.
Okay.
For pizzas.
So did he own a part into this restaurant?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
And he still does?
No, he sold that years ago.
But he worked there and,
yes.
and bought a part.
Right.
Was a piece of it.
Exactly.
Very
so
cool.
He owns a restaurant now in San Diego, California for the last 30 years.
Oh.
And then I decided to do my expansion of these recipes up here in a much more simpler form. So pizza, salad, and wings.
Gotcha. Yeah. No, it's definitely simple. That's what I like about it.
Cool. Well, I appreciate that.
Yeah, I don't like a lot of crazy stuff. I would say though it's a little more Italian style. I mean, is that kind of how it originated?
The idea is for authenticity and quality.
Okay.
So maybe a little bit more Italian and a little less Americana, but
yeah.
You know,
no, but the crust is freaking
thank you.
Awesome. And then the way that you set up the pizza is it's almost like a New York style.
Yes.
Thinner.
Yeah.
But it has like I'm saying it has like this old school artisan feel to it.
Yes.
Which
I appreciate it.
Yeah, no, it's really good.
I
some of the pizzas
that.
I would say, you know, I fly over.
Right.
There's a few where they just have some ingredients where I'm just like, I'm okay. But okay. I've heard a lot of people, you know, they actually dig the stuff. Like there's one I think you have broccoli on there, and I'm like, I'm not gonna eat broccoli on a pizza.
Then that's fine. You know what? Like
But I've heard so many people say they eat broccoli on a pizza. So
And I appreciate that we have something for everybody. You know, it's not like a one-track thing.
Oh, no, you definitely have something for everybody.
Like, we have a pizza with egg on it, so not everybody likes
it. You have a pizza with it? See, I didn't even know that.
But some people like that shit. Me, personally, I made the pizza. I don't need it. But really? But a lot of people like it, you know?
I've had a pizza with an egg, but it was a breakfast pizza.
Okay. All right.
So I think it was, I worked at this place. I worked in a movie theater where we sold food. And the guy made breakfast pizzas, you know, every now and then. We wanted one in the morning, and I think it was like it had eggs on there.
What
it
was restaurant was different. This?
Oh, it's in Salem.
Okay, gotcha.
Over in the valley. Yeah,
is that where you're originally from?
Oh yeah.
Cool.
Yeah, I'm from. Yep.
How long ago did you move up to here?
That was only 3 years ago.
You've been here for 3 years.
Yeah. In fact, I had my an evaluation today at my work.
Oh, congratulations! How'd that go?
It was my three. Oh, it's just like a. It's pretty much like a formality.
Okay.
Like, sit down. Hey, you've been doing this stuff really great.
Okay. Well,
you know what I'm saying, but it's like every year we do it. So yeah.
Congratulations.
It's been 3 years.
Is that why?
So I moved over here for that.
For that.
For that purpose.
What do you do?
I work CAD.
Okay.
So computer aid drafting.
Okay. So this what we're doing now is your side gig.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, for sure.
Oh, it should be my home gig. No, it is my home gig. I'm in my home. It's a side gig. I need to remember to text my wife to go around the fucking back so she doesn't open up the garage.
Are you going to...
Well, I'll be sitting here and... You should have heard it on the last one. We had a plane flyover and a train.
Awesome.
And then I screamed it out, and I'm like, why am I screaming? But
I'm curious, is this what you want to do for your... Not just side gig, but for you.
I like just doing the podcast because it's definitely fun, and it gives me that time that I can, for the brand and everything.
Mm-hmm.
It gives me that social media, whatever have you. This is on YouTube and this is everywhere.
Right.
You can also listen to it on iTunes and all that shit.
That's sweet.
So that's there, but it's meant to, hey, let's drive you to the website because, you know, the podcast is on the website. So you'd be like, oh, podcast, cool, shop. Let's see what's there. You know, I only have a few designs.
Right.
Because I only had just started less than a year ago. So.
Okay. That's how you're cross-marketing in there. With the podcast, you have the t-shirts.
Yeah.
Sweet.
Yeah. So it's just meant to be like that. But the podcast is fun for me.
Right.
This is my thing.
Okay, that's awesome.
A little bit more than whatever.
Right.
I love doing it. I think it's fun. Now I just lost where I was texting. But that's okay. Keep going.
No, that's fine. So were you like super into like radio talk? Like how did you find yourself?
Yeah, no. Fuck, dude. Now you're asking me questions.
What's wrong? Yeah, okay.
No, man. I listen to talk radio.
Okay.
And I like the conversations of it. And yeah, I recently just got into them where it wasn't like I always thought of a podcast being something like you're into, like if let's say I'm into video games or something, so you would go and you could find that video game podcast and they could talk about it and blah 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 blah. And then I found ones where they just talk about whatever the fuck they want and what's going on, and I figured, you know, for just a t-shirt brand or lifestyle brand, whatever you want to say, why not just have this one little piece to it?
Cool.
That's what I thought.
That's neat.
Yeah.
I
don't own a pizza joint though too. I mean, I do.
You think so?
I just go around just doing a bunch of other shit. Yeah, I've had one where my buddy does tattoos.
Okay.
And I want him to come over here to open up a shop because I've heard there's not the best tattooers over here.
I don't know anything about.
Yeah,
it.
I don't know either because I go to him for all mine. Okay. So I go back over to the valley. Talking with him, I'm like, dude, I wish you would just move over here and open up a shop.
I feel like this is a great town for opportunity. Like anything like that, we're missing a lot, and there's a lot of young vibe here.
Yep.
So if you can bring it over, I'd do it.
And the thing is it's not even that far from Bend, and that's what everybody wants to go live there.
Right.
We get it.
Yeah.
But you can save so much money if you go 15 minutes.
I'm moving here in 2 months.
Are you really?
Oh yeah.
Are you looking for a place to buy? Rent?
Rent. Okay. I'm done with Ben. This is where it's at.
Yeah, I was gonna say that. I mean, renting, you're looking at I want to say $300 to $400 difference.
Definitely.
Yeah.
Definitely. And then gas included if you have to commute.
And that's the thing. So across the street, I think I said this on the last podcast because we were talking about this same shit, housing and what you know, whatever. But I think they'll rent those ones, which are townhouses. It's like mine, but just attached.
Okay.
I think they do those for like $1,400, $1,500.
That's awesome.
So you're probably... Oh, that's awesome.
Yeah, that's awesome.
See? So obviously in Ben, it must be way worse.
Yeah,
it's got to be...
It's bad. I'm over it. Needless to say, yeah, over it.
Yeah, I'd be over it. I had the hardest time trying to find a place coming over here because I only had 2 weeks to find a place.
Okay.
And here you put it up on Craigslist, it's gone.
That's sweet.
You know, that... No, it's not sweet. No, the rental that I'm trying to look for...
Oh, here.
When I was in Salem, I would text them or whatever, and they would be, it's gone.
Gotcha.
It's like, fuck. So it was really hard and ended up finding a place really well.
So you mean you're telling me that it's easier to find a place here in Central Oregon than it is in the Valley?
No. It's way worse.
Okay.
No, way worse.
Well, I guess it's a good thing because our market's growing. We're becoming on the map.
Yeah, and everybody's moving here, and, you know, it definitely helps, but...
Maybe now people start to pay attention.
It makes crazy.
Pay attention to things like this. Now this is a thing.
Yeah. It raises the rates too, though. But when you have a demand for it, hey.
Yeah.
You got to go and rock it. That's cool that you're going to move here.
Yes.
Very nice.
I mean, why not?
Yeah, why not? Who cares? Plus it'll be closer to your
my business.
Yeah. Did you originally want to put the business in Bend?
Oh yeah, but you can talk. We're talking about rent.
Uh huh.
Oh my god, it would have been. If throwing out a figure, it would have been $500,000 to do that in Bend.
No shit.
$500,000 to open a business, and who has that type of money?
Holy crap! Yeah, nobody.
Nobody.
That's just crazy.
Yeah. So coming here was kind of a no-brainer.
Yeah. That what used to be a pizza place. So was everything still in there? You didn't have to.
We had a refrigerator and an oven hood.
And that was it?
That was it.
Oh, man. So there wasn't anything in there. So, yeah, pizza stuff I've heard is a lot.
I would say my major pieces of equipment, each one of them is like a small car.
Wow.
Yeah, it's fun. It was fun to do that.
Whew. That would be...
Talk about bank debt.
Yeah, man. But, hey, you got a pizza joint.
It's awesome.
And it's cool.
And yeah.
So I know you have a bunch of pool tables in there. Is that something you're into?
Oh, do I play pool?
Yeah.
I don't, you know, everybody says that they play pool. I own a pizza place with 5 pool tables and I have fun. But,
okay.
You know, it's not like I'm not putting money on top of the table or whatever.
Yeah. Oh, okay. No, I gotcha. Well, I mean, you know, it's a lot of pool tables. So, I mean, you can go in there and you can hang out and play a lot of pool.
Yeah, that's what I like. I like getting people in there. You know, we're trying to do tournaments. Oh, really?
Okay.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Awesome.
Trying to do league, trying to do tournaments, trying to get whoever in to play, hang out, drink beer, eat pizza, play pool. But it's hard. It's hard to reach out.
You guys got a lot of taps, too.
Oh,
thank you. You just said, come drink beer. And it's like, yeah, you guys actually have some really good taps. I've never been up to the new tap house over whatever. Mostly they fuck themselves because they don't allow kids.
Oh, that's terrible. Yeah.
I'll tell you right now, anything in Central Oregon, if you're going to do something like that, you have to allow kids because almost everybody has kids.
Especially here in Redmond, we're a family community.
It's going to start being even more a family community because the people that are moving or, let's say, working in Bend,
right,
they're coming from other places around the U.S., and, yeah, they have families.
Yeah. We're getting younger.
You gotta make sure you can afford it.
Younger, but also more family oriented at the same time. Like a lot of people between like 25 and 35.
Well, that's the thing. Those are the people that are having the kids.
Yes.
The people that are having the kids and they have kids are the ones that like to go and hang out at Crux and, you know, Worthy.
Right.
You go into Worthy, there's never not a kid in there.
It's a great
Like,
great
hate
space.
To say it, but there's never not a kid in there.
Right. And that's Duke, what
you, it's a must. So I've never been to that tap house, so I don't know how many taps they got, but you guys have a shit ton.
Well, I appreciate it. Yeah. It's, you know, we got like 15 or something, and we just kind of,
it's quite a few for, yeah,
for a small place,
especially a pizza place. Cause yeah, usually you go to a pizza place and it's like 1, 2 to 5.
Yes.
Especially, you know.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, you can go up to Jersey Boy and get
50. Oh yeah, that's right. They do have a lot. That's a weird. I don't like that.
But they got, you know, they have lottery machine. It's not this family thing that we're trying to.
Yeah, no. It seems more like a bar. There's definitely no.
I mean, which is great, but it's not. You know, it's not a pizzeria.
Yeah.
No.
Pizza's good though. I love pizza. It'd have to be. I think it's top.
For think.
I could put this out there.
Yeah.
Okay, if you could eat. I'll tell you, pizza's one of them. But if you could only eat one thing for the rest of your life, but it could be that base thing, I think pizza would have to be up there with me.
Oh, of course.
You know what I'm saying?
But you think that would be number one for you?
I think it'd be close to number one. I wouldn't necessarily, I would say per food.
Okay.
Because you can think about it. I can make a breakfast pizza, like I was saying.
All right.
I can make dinner pizzas, I can make dessert pizzas. Like, you can make a shit ton of different styles of pizza. You can make barbecue pizza. You can make a cheeseburger pizza. I've done that before. That's quite delish. Have you ever done that?
I have not done that, but I know of it.
Okay.
I've heard of this.
See, I put it on my Traeger, so it makes the pizza right.
Pizza, huh? You know, I'm gonna have to say for myself, tacos.
Really?
Yeah.
See, I like tacos though too.
Tacos are good.
Tacos would definitely. I mean, burritos.
Yeah.
I think burritos would probably be there for me.
Right on.
On that side.
Does the dessert burrito?
Ooh.
Mm-hmm.
How would you make a dessert burrito?
True.
See, I don't eat too much. I don't eat a lot of sweets. So, yeah. So for me, he's saying dessert burrito. I'm like, fuck.
Well, if you want to make every meal, you gotta.
You definitely have some. Icing.
Oh yeah,
I feel like there's some like caramel in there, maybe.
Probably.
What would be the base though?
Oh, crepe. You'd use crepe instead of tortilla.
Oh well, that wasn't fun.
Sorry, I ruined.
No,
that
you
one.
Had to put it in. Actually, you have to put it in the tortilla in order to classify as burrito.
Why not? Well, I mean, it's the shape.
Hey Google, what classifies a burrito as a burrito?
I just
burrito
lost.
Is a real treat.
You hear that?
Sure it is. She didn't even tell me anything.
But I'll admit I lost that conversation.
No, it's all good. No, I got where you're going though. Yeah, like a pancake burrito. I feel like that'd be hard to hold though.
It might fall apart.
It would probably fall apart. But I feel like a base would have to be, man, I don't know. Some kind of like filling, like a pie filling.
Oh, the base is
the like the filling? Base of the burrito for a dessert burrito, and then you would put like some
churros.
You just go churros.
Churros.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Churros are bomb.
Churros are fucking delicious.
Yeah. churros are. I almost
a churro strawberry Nutella burrito.
He figured it out. He figured it
Game
out.
Game over.
I think this guy likes to get high every now and then, talking about churro burritos.
Is that where this conversation just went to churro burrito?
No. yeah, no, burritos definitely. I was gonna say I could probably do Mexican food and or barbecue for like the rest of my life if I could pick like a whole genre.
Oh, barbecue's delicious.
Is that where you would go?
Where would you eat barbecue? Here.
Where do I eat barbecue? Yeah. Where do you like to go eat barbecue?
Here,
I mean, how long have you been here? Sorry.
8 months and
that's it?
Yeah.
That's so it. So did you guys just decide to move here to open up a place and you found a place and then go, boom, we're doing it?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, that was.
Okay, so 8 months ago you found that place and said, but then you had to find a place to live in Bend.
I would say about a year ago I found that location and 8 months ago I moved here to pursue it.
Awesome. Yep. So yeah, about 4 months of preparing, yep. Kind of checking it. Awesome, dude. That's very cool.
Yeah.
So you moved here and opened it. Not simultaneously. Obviously, you had to put the shit together.
Yes.
But you moved here and automatically just started working on.
Tried to start working on it. Yeah, exactly.
Oh, awesome.
Yeah, very it was cool. A lot of work.
Okay, so yeah, where would you go and eat barbecue?
Here, I've known
since the 8 months.
Oh, I have no idea. I've not had any experiences.
You haven't ate barbecue since you came.
I tried Baldi's once and wasn't impressed.
Okay. Yeah. The Redmond Baldies?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah, it can be like that.
Okay.
Dude, barbecue, man. I would say Wubba's.
I've never even heard of it.
Wubba's is delicious. It's in Bend. And then at Wild Ride, they have a shack, but they don't have their full menu there.
Okay.
But in their... So this will go to your thing, or it'll go to our thing. The Wubburrito, fucking dynamite.
Wubburrito, huh?
It's the Wubburrito, man. I hope this thing will tell me what's on the Wubburrito. It probably won't. Hey, Google, what's on the Wubburrito?
Sorry, I don't know how to.
Of course you don't. Yeah, it can't look up menus. It's not cool like that.
Why doesn't
Google it is delish though. It's like yeah, why wouldn't Google know about fucking the Wubburrito? It should be a national holiday. No, it's good though. It's a big tortilla. I'm gonna just make everybody listening to this, they're gonna be like, dude, I just wanna eat one of these. It's a big burrito. I think it's pulled pork or pulled chicken that you get to pick. And then it's rice, like these certain kind of like pinto beans. Oh dude, I have to just look it up.
So speaking of a barbecue burrito,
yes.
Back where I'm from in Flagstaff, the pulled pork barbecue nachos were like the thing of the town.
Okay.
Everybody was doing a barbecue pulled pork nacho, and this sounds comparably delicious.
Oh, it is definitely up there.
Yeah.
Yeah. I love nachos. Nachos might be another one. You could do a lot of stuff. You could do dessert nachos with your churros and your Nutella.
Yeah, definitely. I'm down.
I think you should make have you ever made the Nutella pizza?
No.
I think it would be good.
Yeah?
Like a mini pizza. I'm just thinking dessert pizzas now. A mini pizza with Nutella on there.
That sounds delicious.
And then some strawberries.
And whipped cream.
And whipped cream.
And yeah, that sounds awesome.
Well, the whipped cream you have to put on afterwards, huh?
Yeah, yeah.
You just kind of like put it in for like what? Maybe like a minute?
Crispy
the crust.
I might add the Nutella, strawberries, and whipped cream after I take the dough out of the oven.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Dough's hot.
Yeah.
Get
there you
it.
Go.
Dude.
There you go.
We're making a whole menu for whatever. Dessert.
My
it's dessert. A whole dessert bar.
My burrito.
Somebody's going to open up a fucking somewhere and it's just going to be dessert stuff. They're going to take this podcast and just straight dessert foods. My wife would love that.
Well, we just gave Redmond the new next big idea.
I don't know what the fuck is up with my internet, but it's definitely not working. So that sucks. This podcast won't be cool. We can't even fucking get shit to work. I've got too many damn things open. That's probably the problem.
What do you need to open on Google?
I was going to Google the Wubburrito. I wanted to tell these people what it actually was the whole way. Give me that Wubburrito. Are you looking it up?
Yeah, thanks, I can, man. If you want.
Yeah, you can look it up. Seeing how my shit don't work, we just got straight up dead air going on right now. It's kind of gross. But yeah, Wubburrito's bomb. Dessert pizza, the Nutella thing sounds bomb.
Sounds like
I can't wait to eat it. You're going to go make it tonight.
Yep. Let's.
You're going to go perfect it.
And put
I'll
it on the
see
menu.
It on the menu.
Next week.
See it on the menu next week. I'll see a Facebook post with the, we got dessert pizza. Let's eat it. No, that sounds really good, though. I like Nutella. Nutella's good.
What's funny about this whole conversation, now it's getting my mind going. I need an ice cream pizza. I need a dessert pizza.
No. You can't do too many. You got to just do the one.
Just change.
Once you overload it, then people are just like, fuck, no, this guy. Dessert pizzas.
He's getting high and making dessert pizzas.
Ice cream pizza. How would that? Oh, you know what? I don't know why this whole podcast has turned into food, but whatever. There was this thing that I heard today, and it was like a breakfast sandwich, deep fried, like a deep fried,
like a Monte Carlo, but breakfast sandwich.
Yeah.
That's
like do
awesome.
Like a sausage patty, maybe the English muffin or whatever. Do a muffin, sausage patty, egg. Oh, we got a call. No, pick it up. Who is it?
Oh, it's from Chula Vista in San Diego. I don't know anybody there.
Okay. They're probably just calling you because you haven't changed your number.
Probably.
Yeah.
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 Yeah. But I'm lazy, so.
Yeah. Once you change your number to here, you'll still get calls, though, so it won't really matter. I forgot what we were talking about for a sec.
Guava burritos.
Guava burritos are so bomb, though. No, the breakfast sandwich.
Breakfast sandwich, yes.
So then you take the I think you would do an egg. I would definitely do an egg and then some sausage gravy.
Let me take
this
call.
Pick it up. Put them on the podcast. Hello?
Hello, this is Ethan speaking.
Hi, I'm calling from the place from Luigi, about Route 519.
Awesome, dude.
You want food from Luigi's?
No, somebody called and placed an order for Ostrander for Luigi's, and they ordered a meatball sub, and we just wanted to call you back and let you know that we do not have meatball subs.
Bro, come on, man. Why ain't you got meatball subs? I love meatball subs, though.
I'm sorry about that, sir.
No, it's okay.
You're slacking, guys. If you don't have meatball subs, then you're not winning it.
Could I then... fuck. Okay, so I can't do the meatball sub. Can I do just like meat with like marinara sauce on it? Just not in balls. Come on, Gene.
All right. Do you guys got pizzas?
We have an Italian sub. So we do like that instead.
Can I get a half large, half medium pizza?
On top of your order already?
Yeah. We'll be in very shortly, sir.
Yeah, I want a half large, half medium pizza.
Okay, so do you want to cancel this order originally?
No, I want it all.
Nah, put that sandwich on there, sir.
The meat sandwich and the half large, half medium.
Can I get that high and tight?
Okay, I'm sorry, I can only hear one person at a time. Can you say that one more time?
I just want the meatball sub high and tight, please. Oh, I thought you did. Oh, shit. Okay. Who is this? Is this Linguini's?
No.
Oh, fuck, dude. I got the wrong place.
Okay.
Yeah, Hitler told me wrong. That was funny. Dude, I'm so glad that just happened. Do you know who that was?
No
idea. Have you ever heard of that restaurant?
No, I thought I was getting a prank call the whole time.
No, I'm glad you picked that up. That was hilarious.
That was great. What was that?
That was some guy trying to get us a meatball sub or not.
I don't know. I think
he had pizzas. We should have asked him, yeah, if he was down for dessert pizzas.
Oh, we missed out. Should I call
him? We missed on the opportunity. I don't know why, but I feel like we just found... what we need to do on podcasts from now on. I'm just gonna start doing prank calls.
Prank calling people?
Yeah,
that sounds.
I
like
think it's
idea.
Allowed. I don't know. Maybe not. Fuck. Now I'm gonna get kicked off YouTube for having some dude. Nah, that's fine.
We could prank call my employees at any time.
How many employees you got
right now working? 2.
Really?
Oh yeah.
People you didn't come here with.
No, the only person who works for me or came with is my girlfriend. Besides that, all young kids.
Oh, yep. Very cool. Two young kids. One making pizzas, one slinging beers.
Exactly.
That's how it goes, dude.
Yep.
That's how it is, man. You just gotta slang it. You just gotta get people that are willing to fucking stand there and do it.
Sweat.
Right.
Sweat. Yeah, it's hard.
Just sweat a little bit. You'll be fine. Everything's all good.
We work hard.
I don't know why my this tip is broken. That was funny, though. Trump, give me some advice, man.
I'm crushing everybody else.
Sure.
Yep.
Fuck, that's hard to... He might be. I don't know. Under his body weight, his wife, or his girlfriends, or his boyfriends.
His wife.
I don't know.
The lady being held captive in that tower.
You think so? Shit, dude. That could be a fucking possibility. That's for sure. Where were we before this fucker interrupted our thing with our what we were talking about? I don't want to go back to dessert pizzas, but I feel like that was key now. Oh, is he calling again?
No.
Oh.
No.
Okay. No worries. Sorry. Yeah.
You know, my girlfriend's asking me where we want to eat for dinner, and we decided Italian was the...
Can we get a pizza? No. Do you only, like, strictly eat pizza at your place, or do you, like...
Me?
Yeah.
I don't eat anything at my place.
Well, that's not good.
I've been eating the same food for 26 years. I don't need this food anymore.
That's how it is, though. I mean,
it's delicious. It's gotten me by, but I don't do it.
I don't want to do it anymore. I know this guy showed up with a thing of rolled tacos, and I was like, I figured you would just be coming in with like some wings that you just had made yourself or something.
No.
He rolls in with rolled tacos.
I'm going to the competition to eat. I'm done.
Nice. Well then, yeah, so you don't eat pizza then? You try to stay away from it?
I will eat pizza if I'm in Chicago, because deep dish is not something I can get on this coast.
Okay.
But besides that, no, I don't do it anymore.
Interesting.
Yeah.
That would be way too hard for me. Yeah. I feel like no matter what, even if I own a pizza joint, I'd probably just eat at that pizza joint all the time. Eating pizza all the time. But
you once you stand in front of a half a 1,000-degree oven for 12 hours at a time, you kind of just... Yeah. It just doesn't do it for you anymore.
I gotcha. Yeah, actually, what's funny is my stepbrother and my half-brother both worked in pizza places.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Yeah, pizzeria-style places.
It's a good business.
I think it'd be very hard to find some pizza that you like. Or do you like just, like, going to other places and eating pizza?
You know, if I in Central Oregon, if I had to eat pizza, I'm going to my shop.
But, yeah, okay.
If I'm somewhere else, you know, I'll try certain pizzas. I'm down.
Very nice.
Yeah.
I was going to say, I like Worthy's pizzas. They're wood-fired.
Oh, that's nice. It's a different style.
Yeah. It's different. Yeah.
It's a different
style.
It's good,
though.
I
like it.
It's more artisan. Like, it's nice, lighter.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so it's good.
I like your guys' pizza, though. It is good. I want people to, start going to it. Hopefully this will help out.
Should use this whole podcast as one big advertisement.
It pretty much is. I mean, that's kind of hopefully the whatever. I don't know. Do a live video. Have you ever done a live video?
I don't even know how to do that. I don't know what an Instagram is.
I feel you don't know what an Instagram is? Did you just call it Instagram?
Isn't that what it's called?
It's called Instagram.
What did I call it?
So I thought you said Instagram.
Oh, Instagram. No, Instagram. Instagram.
Instagram. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. I don't know how to use it.
No, but I just thought about a good one for like a Tinder app, and I feel like this is out there, but an Instagrind.
Oh,
you think you'd get sued on that one?
Nah, I mean, there's...
You think we'll see it Instagrind one of these days?
Instagrind.
That just means you literally wants to instantly grind up on someone. But that's all you do. There's no hump. I mean, there's nothing else except grinding. You're not allowed to do anything else.
Oh, it's for strict grinders.
Yeah, you're straight grinding. So if you're at a bar, you get on your grinder or. See, there's probably a grinder.
There is a grinder.
Okay, it's is a grinder.
It's the homosexual version of Tinder.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Well,
yeah.
Then this makes... So, instant grinder.
Yeah. Instant grinder. Okay.
So, it'd be like instant grinding for gay men.
Sweet.
It's just an avenue for grinder.
Ah.
Now we just helped out grinder. They're going to look at us and go, you guys are fucking morons.
No, I think we're going to make millions.
I never have ever went on any one of those apps... probably never will. I mean, I'm married, but I've never seen how they work.
I did about a 2-week stint back in my senior year of college, and
okay.
Needless to say, it didn't get me what I needed. So
two-week stint. So how many dates? Was it a Tinder?
It was a Tinder, but it didn't pan out. I can't do it. I'm not a. I don't have that online.
I mean,
image.
Did you hang out with any of the chicks?
One time, but she catfished me. Would that? I guess that means that she looked different.
I got. Is there a good story with it? I want to hear it.
No, it's a lame story.
Is it?
She had a very appealing picture. I went to hang out. She wasn't really who she said she was. We smoked some weed, and I had said have a good night. Very lame.
That's a bummer.
So I stick to the meeting, the in person.
Well, I mean, you are calling Instagram, so I get it.
I'm a little.
Yeah, I'm not a. I'm not a big get online and find dates.
Yeah.
I have a buddy that definitely does that, and I'm just like,
if it works, it works. Hey, you got to do what you got to do.
Yeah, if it works, it works, I guess. I just feel if you're on there, you're a little, you're a little whatever. I'm not going to look at my phone anymore. I don't know why I keep doing it. Probably because I'm did I actually send that text message that I said I was going to? Yes, I did. All right. That'll work. Cool. Well, shit, dude. I'm hoping your camera doesn't go on out here pretty quick.
Is it
looking at it. Yeah, it's about 40 minutes right now, so we're Probably looking at 5 minutes and the fucker's going to die like a little
I mean, that's okay.
Yeah. Instagram's cool, though. I like it because, yeah, it's just photos.
My girlfriend
photos more than anything.
My girlfriend keeps trying to take pictures of our food and put it on there. And
she should.
I think it would probably, I mean, you know, same thing as this. Just kind of get it
out
there.
Yeah, but that's the thing, man. People put food all the time, mm-hmm. and that's what you guys are selling. And they always look good. If it looks good, it will look good. You know?
Yep.
Just like any other advertisement, except McDonald's, what you get is what is not the picture. But what you're bringing to the table is what the fucking picture is, because it's instant. Be like, it just came out of the fucking oven. You see that smoke coming off?
That'd be pretty cool.
That's killer.
Is that your trademark?
No. No, I ain't got no fucking trademark. No.
Now you do.
I've got, when every day's the weekend, I guess you could trademark that. No, you can't. There was a song like that. That's where I actually got it. I took it from the song.
What song?
When every day's the weekend. This song is called that.
By who?
Asking Alexandria.
Okay.
You ever heard of them?
I've heard of them.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, I just was listening to it one day, and I was like, because I was trying to figure out what I should name the podcast. And then I heard the song, and I like the song. And I looked at the name of it because for some reason nowadays I don't remember names of songs anymore.
Okay.
Do you remember that back in the day when you'd have like a CD?
Yes.
And you would be like, oh, what song is this? And you'd be like, that's this title. Like you would know exactly the title and the person.
You have a limited amount of CDs.
Now I only know the person.
Yeah. Right. But
because I have my iPod. It's just it's always on shuffle.
Right.
You know. I went to click on what, and then it said the name, and I was like, actually, that'd be a dope name for the podcast.
Every day is the weekend, huh?
That's when it came.
Yep.
Yeah.
Some post-hardcore.
That was it.
Yep.
I always have fun doing these things.
This is cool. I definitely do enjoy this.
Well, the best part is in the beginning, this is only the fourth one, but the very first one, it's just you have these like things that you see and you notice that you want to fix. So then you fix them for the next one, and then there's other things, and then there's...
Right.
So I'm kind of getting to the point where I'm pretty much right there in it.
Getting it down?
That's a little bit. Conversations kind of go a little in and out.
I started to realize that, like, at the pizza place, we also do shows, and I've never ran the venue before. So it's like learning, you know, one time I noticed I fucked up this, and the next time I messed up that. So now we're doing, like, our sixth show tonight, and...
You're doing a show tonight?
Yeah, we're doing a show tonight.
Dude! I'm fucking rolling.
Bluegrass and country.
I love some bluegrass, man. Do you know who they are? Who are they?
Shoot Dang from Portland.
Shoot Dang?
Yeah.
Have you ever heard of them?
No, I've never heard of them. I don't actually listen to country or bluegrass, so this is more for my customers rather than me. So, you know.
Okay. How many people you got going?
It says on Facebook that there's going to be 20, probably some band members.
Dude, that's legit.
Hopefully we'll bring like a crowd of 30, 40
are you gonna people. Be? Are you gonna go and hang out? I mean,
I gotta work it. So.
Oh, you gotta work. Yeah. What time are you going to go do that then?
I'll be in there at 8.
Okay. So how does that work out? I mean, setting it up, because I mean, it's not like your location is fully set up for a concert.
No. We have a booking organization there.
Okay.
They go by the name of Ben Pirate Punks.
Okay.
And they do all my booking for me. They bought like a light system, and we're building a little stage. It's pretty neat.
Cool.
Turning my little pizza shop into a mini venue.
Mini venue. That's awesome.
I dig it.
No, that's really cool. I love that. Yeah. Yeah, because I've always wanted to be like, I just want to throw a concert together or whatever. And then how do I get the sound? How do I do it? It's like, I don't know shit.
Yeah. It's good to have booking.
So you're like, I'll just go somewhere and listen. No, I tried to do that for my birthday one time. I was like, yeah, I can set up. So I went on to like and found like Portland bands and was like, hey, do you guys want to come down and play for like $100? You know, I found them on like, I think Pure Volume. At the time.
Okay.
But does anybody use Pure Volume anymore?
What is Pure Volume?
Pure Volume is like a sound, like SoundCloud.
Like Instagram?
No. Do you know what SoundCloud is? So this is on SoundCloud. It's for, you know, music.
Okay.
You can throw up your tracks if you're an artist or you have a podcast. And then it also syncs from there to iTunes, and that's how it gets on iTunes.
Gotcha.
But Pure Volume, same kind of deal. In fact, I actually have my shit on there too because I did beats in high school. Okay. I made like 4 or 5 beats and fucking threw them on Beer Volume.
Sweet.
It's fucking hilarious. But yeah, so I think I listened to, you know, and you can get their email. So I just would email the bands.
Yeah.
Hey, I'm thinking about doing like a concert. Do you guys just bring your own shit? And they're like, yeah, we can just bring our stuff and play. I was like, okay, cool. Never happened though.
Ah, bummer. What would you do it if it did happen?
I would have rocked out at a fucking concert for my birthday.
Sweet.
That'd have been cool.
Yeah.
Invite a bunch of people, hang out. Probably would have charged though.
That's a good way to make money.
Make money.
Yeah,
I gotta make some fucking money. No. What was the band called? Sorry.
Shoot Dang.
Shoot. I'm gonna see if this thing will finally work. If not, then I know that I've my internet could be messed up. It's just going slow. Maybe it's because of the rain. Well, yeah, I think I'll come down.
That'd be really cool.
Yeah, I'll check it out.
I'm excited for it. You know, we had this massive hip-hop show last weekend. And
really?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Like 110 people showed up.
No way.
It was crazy.
Dude.
It was crazy.
Fuck. How do I not know this shit?
It's all on our Facebook.
I know, but I don't get the alert.
You gotta follow us.
I do.
I post it. I post all the shows.
Damn it.
Yep.
I think what I'll do is I'll just start looking at your website or whatever. Do you guys have or just the Facebook?
Yeah, we have a website, but I just post it all on the Facebook.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. But, you know, we're doing shows close to every weekend now.
Very cool.
Yeah. I'll try to do all the genres. Punk awesome. And hardcore.
Punk, hardcore, hip-hop, obviously, hip-hop. Like you said.
Yeah.
I mean, you got 100 people in there.
It was sweet.
Yeah.
It was sweet.
Well, that's awesome.
Yeah.
Were you guys doing By the Slice for that?
Yep. We always do we do like a slice at the door type of thing, like your ticket includes a couple slices.
No way.
Yeah.
That's cool.
Yeah.
Oh,
try to mix it up.
So yeah, so you get
your show.
You're coming in for the show.
And dinner.
By the way, you're eating dinner. Instead of let's do the show, let's say for free.
Right.
And then expect people to then buy
step
out.
Yeah.
That's cool.
And, you know, the artists get a cut and the organization, they're just booking gets a cut. It's
okay.
Good. It's good for everybody.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's definitely good for everybody.
Plus you're also, you know.
People get to
so
eat
where are you going to, I know nobody knows the fucking layout that's listening to this, but where are you going to be putting the stage? Like the building, it's kind of the main, I would say, area. It's just it's kind of a square.
It is a square.
Yeah, it's just a square.
Top right corner.
Top right.
Yep.
So close to.
Opposite the door.
Opposite the door. So you come in.
You walk up to the top right corner by where the napkin station is.
Okay.
And
that's where I was thinking.
Yep.
And yeah, that's exactly where I was thinking.
Generally, drum set goes right there.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, and everything's kind of based around that, and we.
So is that where the stage? What you're saying is going to be built, or you're going to have
a roll away?
Roll away stage.
Yep.
Oh, there you go.
Yeah,
even
we're
better.
Excited.
That's cool. Yeah, fucking roll away stage.
It's
pizza.
Yeah, it's gonna
I'm down.
Until you know, we're gonna do it till we get shut down.
I'll come
down
after I eat though. No, 8 o'clock's a little late. Kids will be getting ready for bed, but I'll come down.
Sweet man. Thank you.
I'd come check it out. I want to listen to the band before. I mean, I might not come down if they suck.
They might suck. You never know.
Well, if my fucking internet would work, but hey.
Yeah, I can buy it.
You know what? There's a day
that shit.
When, well, I was going to say because I could play it through the headphones. And then that way we can listen to it and not have to worry about fucking up the podcast. Because you can't play music through it.
Yeah. Gotcha.
Yeah.
Why? Just too much feedback or something?
No, because copyright.
Oh.
Artists.
Well, you think Shoot Dang is gonna be upset?
See, I don't know. I don't know if Shoot Dang will give a fuck, but I'd rather listen to Shoot Dang before I put it on this shit.
Right. I mean, the Chili Peppers might give a shit, but I don't know about Shoot Dang.
Yeah. They might not even give a shit.
They're pretty punk rock.
Most people don't give a shit. Actually, I have no clue. I would just think record labels would. But I don't know. Music's weird nowadays. Music's gone, I think, back to... I think everybody should just do their own shit.
What do you mean?
Like, just figure out a way to do it on your own.
Just
like,
keep it DIY.
Yeah, because I feel like there's so many easy ways of putting your music out there that you would actually make more money touring. See, there goes your camera. Just keep going. But I feel like, well, I guess I'll walk away though while I'm talking. But I feel like with music, you can make a lot of money touring.
Okay.
And off sales, off your CD, off your music, per song. And I feel like you'd just be better off doing that on your own.
Mm-hmm.
Put it on, make your own website.
But that involves touring, and like, what if you're a high school kid that, like, you know?
So you need the money for touring. I get that. Every time I watch any tour videos of bands, you know, that I'm into or whatever, they're always in some shitty fucking van, and they're always like saying they're scraping for money. Okay, so, I mean, is the record label really helping you at that point then?
Well, a lot of these indie bands, you know, they're not on a record label.
They're doing it on their own.
Doing it on their own dime, and that's not always easy. Like, I mean, I guess if you don't have the drive, then why are you in
the
band?
But why give away a percentage of your band because, you know, this person's now going to easily get it online? It's like, it already go online. But the promoting, I guess. Maybe the promotion's there.
And get you
But that's the thing. There's almost none of the bands that I listen to get promoted. The only way I find them is I Google them.
Okay.
Or, you know what I mean?
Right. I mean, I still listen to a lot of bands on Fat Records, and, you know, if I want to find a new band, like, I just go on to fatrec.com and see all the new up-and-comers. And
usually that I go to the record label that I know. Yeah. So I guess it does put that out there. But I'm just saying, if you wanted to do it yourself, I don't think it would be that hard.
Yeah, for sure.
And I don't know if I feel like I'd want to go that way, you know? So like, I own 100%, fuckers.
For example, one of the young kids who works for me, Cody T, throwing his name out there, he's a hip-hop artist, and, you know, all the kids at Ridgeview High, he doesn't even go to Ridgeview High, all the kids at Ridgeview know this kid.
Yeah.
It's like, he's like celebrity to them.
Really?
Because he just put it on that SoundCloud thing and blew up in the local high school.
Exactly.
Yep.
Now, if he wanted to, he could go on, he could build a website, he could charge.
Yeah.
You could start charging a dollar per song or 50 cents per song,
whatever,
you know?
People will pay.
Like, hate to say it, but 50 cents per song times blah blah blah,
it's a lot of money.
It's a lot of fucking money.
It's a good idea.
Yeah. So why give that to
somebody
you
else,
you know? And then finance your own tour.
You hear that, Cody T? It's for you.
Is that his rapper name?
That is his rapper name.
What's his real name?
Cody Taylor.
That was a far stretch.
Yeah, he's real creative.
He really stretched that one out there. Cody T.
Who do you think he is, Seal?
Yo, what's my name? Cody T.
I don't give a fuck. That's one of
the songs. Is it really?
Yeah.
Okay. Is it pretty? I mean, is it pretty good?
Oh yeah.
Do you guys play it every now and then in the pizza place? You're like, Cody T, I'm gonna put your music on,
you know,
bro.
He's played live 3 times throughout his career, and they've all been at D Pizza.
Nice.
Yeah.
Do you guys get do you get a bunch of Ridgefield kids in there?
Oh, tons.
That's how it rolls.
Like 40 people. It's cool.
What I'm gonna do is fucking get you some shit then.
Sweet. What shit?
We'll get him a shirt or something.
Oh, that'd be sweet.
Yeah, actually, just have him go onto the website. Tell me what shirt he would want.
Okay.
I'll get him one. He just has to wear it the next time he's at your pizza place putting on a performance.
Dude, if he was performing, I'd have him wear that shirt.
And tell him then, you know.
Cool.
This podcast is pretty much all about Central Oregon for the most part, and just a bunch of bullshit, so.
I like it.
Yeah. Yeah, we talk podcasts. No, we talk to Central Oregon. We talk it all the time, man. It's crazy. Everything seems to be fucking up on my computer. I don't know what's really going on, but... Well, shit, dude. You got 3 more hours, you know, 2 more hours until you got to be there, so I guess we'll just sit now.
You know what? Actually, I actually have to go get that dessert pizza and crepe burrito.
No, you don't. God, that sounds so good. You're going to go back and you're going to start perfecting it with Nutella and fucking some strawberries and shit.
No, my girlfriend and I are gonna go meet up for some Italian food.
And then gonna head back to the concert. Are you? So you said you're gonna work it.
Yes.
So you're not gonna be able to sit around and.
No, I don't get to enjoy myself. I pour beer and clean up and make pizzas.
Very cool.
Yeah.
Yeah, I might come down. I'm gonna listen to them first. I gotta fix my internet before I can get on there.
Yeah, yeah. Check them out and.
If not, then I'll come to the next concert I'll see you around too.
It's all on DPizza or Ben Pirate Punks.
Ben Pirate Punks, is that who you go through for?
Yeah, for booking.
For booking?
Yeah, they're really
And they
cool
even
guys.
Did the hip-hop booking?
They did the hip-hop. They're
they just call themselves the Pirate Punks.
They're all pretty punk rock, grungy guys. But cool. They're all really nice.
I'll have to get one of them on the podcast.
That'd be sweet. I'm sure they would totally dig it.
Maybe they will. Maybe they won't. Fuck it. All right. Well, thanks, man.
Thank you.
Fucking digged it, dude.
That was fun.
I haven't done this in a while, so it was good to get the fuck out here and make it happen. So.
Yeah.
All right. Everybody, go to the fucking website if you want to go buy something. I forgot to put up two different shirts, so this is the same two shirts as the last podcast, so fuck. Whatever.
And eat a deep pizza.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Go check out the fucking pizza place. The problem is if people are listening that aren't around here, they're going to be like, fuck that pizza place. I don't even know where that's at.
How do you not know where?
But hopefully we'll start getting people that live here watching this because it's about Central Oregon, man.
There you go.
We're just people. We hang out, do drugs,
kick it.
Later, fuckers. I tiptoe on a fence with both sides displaying painted targets on the dark side of the moon where they lay my naked carcass. I'm not ready for a fall, but down to start in autumn, turning each and every leaf the way these teachers never taught us. Running out of options, destination weighing on the bank or not to bank, or which way we should be taking. The mind is not a safe place, but don't admit you get scared to hear footsteps upstairs when no one lives there. There.